There's an interesting feature on Japanese keyboards that you may not have heard of, and I'm going to introduce it to you today and hopefully demonstrate how we could introduce it into the English keyboard. Now, I'm not using a script or anything today, so through the power of editing, I'm hopefully going to be able to explain this to you easily. If you stay tuned to the end of the video, for those who are interested, I'll give a little bit more background information to the Japanese keyboard, how it works, and the different kinds of settings that can change the way you write Japanese. So on Japanese keyboards, if you want to type a symbol such as beta, or beta for you Yanks out there who destroy languages for some reason, you would type it in as you would a normal Japanese word. In Japanese, it is beta. So if we type in beta, how we would the actual word in Japanese, and press space, the symbol will come up and you can select from there. The reason that this happens is, unlike English, where A is always A and B is always B, Japanese phonemes have many symbols attached to them. That's the beauty of kanji, I suppose, but it also makes it incredibly difficult to know the right symbol for the right time unless you've grown up with the language or spent years learning. As a result, it comes with a exceptionally cool feature where you can type almost any symbol you want as long as you know the Japanese word for it. Common example I could go for is if I type up, up, down, down, left, right, B, A, start. Ue, ue, shita, shita, hidari, migi, hidari, migi. Up, up, down, down, left, right. Super, super simple in Japanese. Do that in English, you're going to be Googling. Or you're going to be using what's called alt codes. Now, alt codes are quite cumbersome because you have to remember the associated code with it, and nobody has time for that. And unless you're really, really well versed in what alt codes are, it's going to take a long time to remember them all. I came up with a small solution. I created a JavaScript extension for Chrome. I'm not very good at JavaScript, but I thought I'd give it a go anyway. This is one of the worst implementations of a Chrome extension you can do. However, the functionality kind of works. Let's go back with beta. So I went with the shortcut Control, Shift, and K, and then it will come up with a dialog box of a variety of different symbols that could match what you're looking for. It doesn't just work with beta. We can also try it with copyright. Copyright's a great one. Control, Shift, K, and then press Enter to select, and you've got the copyright symbol. Very simple stuff. As I mentioned, this is not a very good implementation. I will put the code, a link to GitHub in the description box below, as well as a CodePen version. So if you are a tinkerer, you can go in there and make it better, fix it yourself. So Japanese typing on keyboards can come in two different formats. We can either type with the symbols that are written on the keyboard almost the same way you would in English. So on A is the symbol for chi, or on T is a symbol for ka. You could type with that directly. Japanese people, surprisingly, very seldom use that. What they tend to do is type in romaji, or Roman characters. When typing in romaji, you would type it just like you would an English sentence. So let's go with a very simple word. If we want to type karate, I would type it K-A-R-A-T-E, karate. And then you press space to select the kanji. That's the way most people do it. I've been in Japan for a few years and I've met one person who uses the symbols that are actually written on the keyboard. Similarly, on your phone, you can do two different ways. You can do the typing as you would that I just described, typing the English characters and getting the Japanese alphabet. Side note, alphabets is technically incorrect. The reason alpha and beta join together to bring alphabet, A and B. Just a little side note. I'm never going to scold anybody who calls it the Japanese alphabet. It's typical vernacular. The way that I tend to write Japanese is with the Japanese style of writing. So once again, if I type karate, get karate the kanji, and it will come up into that list. One thing to know, you can either tap to go through each of the k sounds, for example, or what I tend to do is swipe. So up for ku, right for ke, down for ko and left for ki. If I want to just have ka, right in the middle. And it's the same kind of system for each of the letters, let's say. So yeah, very quick video. I just wanted to show that out to the world, and hopefully you've learned something, and maybe you've even gotten a little bit of inspiration to start a little project yourself. Do what I made, but make it so much better. Give it a nice interface. Maybe make it more usable. Mine, as it stands, is not very usable. So thank you very much for watching, and who knows, maybe I'll make another video about something else I find quite interesting or intriguing.